we were reading a new book, and I had one little girl who was just really struggling with the book, and she was trying to sound out some of the words, but she was just having some problems. And so about halfway through the book, she just closed the book and she slid the book across the table to me and said, "You know what, Miss Buckley? I don't need to know how to read this book because I'm going to be a supermodel. And whenever I'm a supermodel, I don't have to read these books."
Reading is one of the most dazzling mental skills that people learn. We seldom think about just how much is involved. Our eyes move from left to right in a series of quick leaps, resting or fixating on a word for a sliver of a second before moving ahead.
Okay, if you could look straight ahead, please.
Okay. At the University of Massachusetts, a research lab is investigating what good readers do with their eyes. Dr. Keith Rayner is director of the lab.
I've spent my life using eye movements as a way to understand reading and scene perception and visual search and other things, because it seems to me that eye movements are a very good indicator of the mental processes that people engage in.
Okay, could you look at the upper right-hand corner of the screen, please?
Dr. Rayner has found that skilled readers take in information from a surprisingly small area around the fixation point. 3 or 4 letters to the left of fixation, and about 15 letters to the right.
Simply because of the physical wiring of the eye, you don't get much detail outside the point that you're looking at. You can try this experiment for yourself. Hold up your hand just a little bit off the line of sight, and you won't even be able to count your own fingers. That's how fuzzy it gets. So if you need fine detail, whether you're looking at a P or a Q or an H or a J, your eye has got to land right on the word. And indeed, studies of eye movements in reading have shown that good, even skilled, rapid readers pretty much land on every content word.
Good readers seldom backtrack. They fixate on each word for a quarter second before leaping ahead 8 or 9 letters.
Could you look straight ahead, please?
Good readers are highly systematic. Younger, less skilled readers spend more time on each word. They leap ahead shorter distances, and they back up more often.
They're going much slower because they're having much more difficulty encoding what the words are that they look at.
Though they are slower, young readers follow the same pattern as adults. They don't hunt around a page for context clues, but instead decode one word at a time as their eyes move methodically across the text.